Now here we are going to see problem on design of shaft. Let us see the problem. Determine the diameter of solid shaft for the following case. The pulley C drives, this is the arrangement of the shaft with the two pulleys C and D here. Pulley C is of 0.6 meters diameter and pulley D of 0.4 meter diameter. The shaft is placed in two bearings and these two bearings are separated at a distance of 1 meter and this pulley C is placed from A at a distance of 0.3 meters and this pulley D is placed from B at a distance of 0.2 meters. And here if you see, the pulley C drives another pulley which is placed directly below it with the help of belt. So this pulley C is driving another pulley which is placed below, exactly below to this shaft with the help of a belt having maximum tension of 2.25 kilonewtons. So if you see in the side view, this is the pulley C and it is driving another pulley with the help of belt means. So this this two lines are showing belt and this T1 and T2 are the tensions in the belt. And let us say this is the maximum tension in the belt T1 and here and T2 is the minimum tension. Let us take like that and this maximum tension is given 2.25 kilonewtons and here the data the pulley D is driven by an electric motor and belt which is placed horizontally to the right. So here if you see, there is another pulley D which is driven by an electric motor with the help of belt placed horizontally. So this D is driven by one more electric motor with the help of belt placed horizontally. So if you assume these two lines as a belt which is going to a motor, so this T3 and T4 are tensions in the belt which is there on the pulley D. And here let us take T3 is the maximum tension. Let like that we take and like that we assume. And here the pulley D is driven by electric motor which is placed horizontally to the right and the angle of contact of both pulleys is 180 degrees, means the angle of belt which is making with the pulleys is on both the pulleys is 180 degrees and mu is the risk coefficient of friction between the belt and the pulley is 0.24. Taking allowable working stress of 63 megapascal in tension and 42 megapascal in shear, assume that torque on one pulley is equal to the torque on another pulley. So here what is this means? This shaft is given with two pulleys C and D of different diameters. This C is driving one more pulley which is placed exactly below it and this D is driven by an electric motor with the help of belt. So D is driven by electric motor which is placed horizontally. So this arrangement is showing horizontal arrangement and C is driving what driving another pulley vertical limits. This arrangement is showing vertical driven mechanism. So here we have to find out the diameter of this shaft for this case. So here what happens means this T1 and T2 will apply vertical load on the shaft at C and this T3 and T4 will apply horizontal load. So why? Because when it is driving, these tensions in the belts are pulling this pulley C downwards and also D is driven with horizontal drive, means this T3 and T4 are pulling the shaft at D horizontally. So at C, vertical load is acting at D, horizontal load is acting. So we have to find out the movements because of this vertical and horizontal loads. and we have to find out the resultant moments, and we have to pick up the maximum moment here. And also, because this shaft is rotating with the help of these pulleys, it is also subjected to twisting moment. So we have to take so this shaft is subjected to twisting and bending movement because of these loads. So it is happening simultaneously. So we have to use the equivalent twisting moment and equivalent bending moment equation, and we have to find out diameters. From that we have to select a suitable diameter. So that's what we have to going to do here, to find out the diameter of the shaft. So to do that, we have to find out vertical loads and horizontal loads at each point, and we have to find out movements, and we have to find out resultant movements, and we have to pick up a maximum movement. So let us see step by step here. So let us take T1 is the tension in the tight side of the belt on pulley C, that is 2250 newtons. It is given in the question, 2.25 kilonewtons I'm converting into newtons. And T2 is the tension slack side of the on the pulley C. Let us take like that. And angle of contact of the belt on both pulleys is given 180 degrees. Coefficient of friction mu is given 0.24. Allowable working stress and tension is given 63 megapascal or 63 newton per mm square. Allowable working stress and shear is given 42 megapascal or 42 newton per mm square. So here T1 is given 2250 newtons, and we have relation of ratio of belt tensions as T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. T1 is given, substitute here, and mu and theta, substitute theta value in radians. So here it is given 180 degrees, so it is nothing but pi radians. So when you substitute that and when you simplify, we are getting T2 as 1058 newtons. So here we can write a vertical load acting on C as T1 plus T2. So if you see here, this belt or these belt tensions T1 and T2 are pulling the shaft at C. So this two tensions will combinedly apply a vertical load on the shaft at C. So to get vertical load on the shaft at C, we are adding T1 plus T2, that is 2250, and 1058, that is 3308 newtons. And vertical load acting on the shaft at D. You see here, there is no mechanism, driving mechanism, which is placed horizontally, vertically at D. So there is only horizontal driving mechanism. So there is no vertical load on the shaft at D. So that is vertical load acting on the shaft at D is zero. Next. So this is a diagram showing vertical loads. And this will be treated as simply supported beam, because the shaft is placed on the two bearings which are acting supports. So if you take like that, simply supported beam. So we get reactions at B and A because of vertical load acting at C, that is 3308 newtons. So this diagram is showing vertical loading diagram on the shaft. So at C it is 3308 and D is 0. And if you see, we have to find out horizontal loads on the shaft. So this T3 tensions in the belt, T3, T4 will apply horizontal load on D. So horizontal load on the shaft at D is T3 plus T4. And horizontal load at C is 0, because at C there is no horizontal driving mechanism. So to find out T3 and T4, we know the ratio of belt tensions. Once again, we are using T3 by T4 is equal to e power mu theta. So mu value is given 0.24, and theta value, same value is given. That is already said, take same value for both the pulleys. So same values we are taking for mu and theta. And if you simplify that, we are getting T3 by T4 as 2.125. And also to find out T3, T4, we require one more relation. For that, we are using the hint that in the problem is given, torque on the pulley C and D are same. So we are taking torque is equal to T3 minus T4 into RD is equal to T1 minus T2 into RC. So friends, see here, if you take at C, if you want to write torque equation, so this T1 and T2 are are the tensions in the belt. So this pulley or ultimately the shaft will rotate because of the difference in the tensions, that is the driving force. So and multiplied by this radius to get the torque at C. So T1 and T2 are both are tensions. They are acting downwards, no doubt, but to drive this in particular direction. So the difference in tensions is nothing but a driving force multiplied by, it will act tangentially or at the periphery, multiplied by this radius will give a torque at C. So that's what we have written in the equation. T1 minus T2 into RC, that is also nothing but T3 minus T4 into RD, because is given torque on both pulleys is same in the question. So if you write torque at D, so it is nothing but T3 minus T4 into RD. So both are same, we have equated that both. So T1, T2 we have calculated already. So substitute those values, and RC by the diagram we know it is 0.3 because diameter is given 0.6. So we have written like that, and we are getting torque as 357.6 Newton meters. So take that torque to find out T3 minus T4. So we can write from here, T3 minus T4 into RD is also equals to same torque, 357.6. So if you simplify that, we are getting T3 minus T4 as 1788 Newtons. So when you solve this 1 and 2, we are getting T3 as 3376 Newtons and T4 as 1588 Newtons. So horizontal load acting on the shaft at D is nothing but T3 plus T4. So that is 3376 plus 1588. So that is 4964 Newtons. And also horizontal load at C is 0. That I told already, there is no horizontal driving mechanism at C. So horizontal load at C is 0 and D is 4964 Newtons. So here find out maximum moment for vertical loading. So here we have to find out the bending moments. So why? Because of the vertical loads and horizontal loads, the shaft will bend. So we have to find out vertical movement and horizontal movement at each place, that is at C and D. And we have to take resultant movement at C and D if you see in the diagram. So here this T1, T2 and T3, T4 are creating vertical load at C here, and this T3, T4 horizontal load. So at each place we have to find out vertical movement and horizontal movement, and we have to take resultant at C and also at D, and we have to take a maximum of these two as a bending moment, and we have to equate the equivalent bending moment, find out diameter. So that's what we are doing here. So find out that, first of all, find the maximum moment for vertical loading. So from the vertical loading diagram, if you see here, we have already calculated this is a vertical loading diagram, 3308 at C and D, it is 0. And because of this load, we are getting reaction set A and B, that is RA, RB is reaction set A and B, and I have written B because it is a vertical. So the reaction because of vertical load at A is RAV, reaction at B because of vertical load is RBV. So if you write that, RAV plus RBV is nothing but 3308. And also, if you take sum of moments at about A and equal to 0 to get reaction forces. So if you take RBV into this distance is 1 given in the question, and if this is positive, if you take like that, and minus 3308 into 0.3, 3308 into 0.3, sum of moments about A is 0. That we are doing here. So if you take this RBV moment as positive, this will become negative. That's we are doing here. RBV into distance is 1, that we have written, and if I am taking this as positive, and here this 3308 into this distance is 0.3 is 0. To calculate reaction forces, we are doing this. And so if you simplify that, we are getting RBV as 992.4 Newtons and RAV as 2315.6 Newtons. So we got reaction forces also. So find out moments, bending moments at each point B, D, C, A because of these vertical loads. So we know that forcibly supported beam at the supports movement is zero. So anyway, bending moment at B because of vertical loading is zero, and bending moment at D. So if you see, I require bending moment at D, I can write RBV into this distance. So RBV into this distance is 0.2. So RBV value is, we got 992.4 into 0.2. We are getting it as 198.5 Newton meter. And find out bending moment at C also. So bending moment C, we can write RAV into 0.3. So friends, you can calculate from this end, means you can start here and you can calculate at this end. You can follow the general procedure of calculating bending moments. That is nothing but start from here, calculate movement at each every point from this, from starting point. Or also you can write like this also. That is, if you require bending moment at D, you can write RBV into 0.2, and we got that. And if I require bending moment at C, I can write RAV into 0.3 directly to get movement at C. So that's what we have written. I have written RAV into 0.3. So that we got, I got 694.7 Newton meter. So anyway, you can do, you will get the same values. And because A is simply support, so you get bending moment at A as 0 here. So in the same way, find out the maximum bending moment for horizontal loading also. So here, if you see, this is the horizontal loading diagram. We got horizontal load at D as 4964 in the previous case. So this load will create moments in the perpendicular direction to this diagram. So RAH and RBH as the reaction forces because of this horizontal load 4964. And the same manner as discussed in the previous vertical loading case, find out reaction forces RAH, RBH. So we know that sum of forces to one direction is nothing but sum of forces other direction. So I am not telling vertical upward, vertical downwards, because this is the horizontal loads. So sum of forces in one direction is nothing but sum of other forces. So RAH plus RBH is 4964, and taking moment support A. So here, if you see, RBH into 1 is sum of movement, means this is one movement, and that must be equals to 4964 into this distance. If you remove 0.2 here, we are getting 0.8 here. So I have written like that. So anyway, taking sum of movements about A and equating to 0, I can write like this equation. And if I simplify that, I am getting RBH as 3971 newtons and RAH as 993 newtons. And let us calculate movements at B, D, C, A because of horizontal loading. So as I told, it is a simply supported beam. We are taking it as simply supported, or this is nothing but simply supported beam case. So it supports, you will get bending moment as 0 that we have discussed. So I have written 0. So if I require bending moment at D because of this horizontal loading, I can write RBH into 0.2. So I have written RBH into 0.2, and substitute those values, I am getting moment as 794.2. And at C, I can write RAH into 0.3. RAH into 0.3. So RAH value, we got 993 into 0.3. I am getting 297.9 Newton meter, and it is a support. At A is support, we will get movement 0. And here we have to find out resultant movement at C and D. We have calculated movement at C because of vertical loading, and also movement at C because of horizontal loading. And also we have calculated movement at D because of vertical loading, and movement at D because of horizontal loading. So at these two places, and remaining A and B, we got, or we know, movements are 0. So at these two places we got a horizontal movement and vertical movement. So here we have to find out resultant movement at these two places. So this is given by this relation, you know, because these two are perpendicular to each other. You can write resultant movement at C as MC. We are taking under root of BM CV square plus BM CH square, that is bending movement at C because of vertical loading square plus bending movement at C because of horizontal loading. So we got these values as 694.7. If you see bending movement at C because of vertical loading, 694.7, and horizontal movement is 297.9, that we have written here. And if I simplify that, I'm getting resultant movement at C as 756 Newton meter. It is the same way resultant movement at D is nothing but movement because of vertical loading square plus movement because of horizontal loading. So we got this as a vertical load at D as vertical movement at D as 198.5 Newton meter, and movement because of horizontal load at D as 794 point something. So we have written those, and we are getting resultant movement at D as 819.2 Newton meter. So if you observe here, the resultant movement at C is 756 and resultant movement at D is 819 Newton meter. So because resultant movement at D is more, so this movement we are taking as a maximum movement, bending movement acting on the shaft at D. So maximum movement we are taking as 819.2 Newton meter. And torque we got in the previous case, we calculated in the first steps, that is 357.6 Newton meters. So equate this maximum movement and torque to the equivalent twisting movement case and equivalent bending movement case, because this torque and movement are acting simultaneously. So if you see, we have calculated movements because of vertical and horizontal loads, and we have calculated resultant movement, that we have taken maximum movement. So bending movement is acting, and at the same time the shaft is rotating with some torque we have calculated. So torque and bending movement acting simultaneously. So for that purpose we have to take equivalent twisting movement and equivalent bending movement equations to find out diameter of the shaft. So if we take equivalent twisting movement, we know that formula T is equals to under root of m square plus t square, where m is the maximum movement acting, resultant movement acting on the shaft, that we got 819.2 square, and torque we got 357.6 square. If we simplify that, I am getting as equivalent twisting movement as 894 Newton meter, convert into Newton mm, 894 into 10 to the power of 3, because we have to find out diameter of the shaft in mm. I am converting equivalent twisting movement in mm, and we know that we have to equate this equivalent twisting movement to twisting strength of shaft by taking allowable shear strength of shaft material. So that we know solid shaft twisting strength is given by, torsional strength is given by pi by 16 into tau into d cube. So when you equate this to this twisting strength, we are getting diameter as 47.6. and also we know that equivalent bending moment formula as me is equals to half into m plus under root of m square plus t square, and this under root of m square plus t square is nothing but t. So that I can write m plus t here, and m we got 819.2, and this equivalent t we got here 894, that is 856.6 Newton meter, or 856.6 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton meter to Newton mm. So you will get 10 to the power of 3. So equate this equivalent twisting movement to equivalent bending movement to the bending strength of a shaft by taking allowable bending stress, that is nothing but normal stress only. So that is, we know that equation for solid shaft, 5 by 32 into sigma into d cube. So this 856.6 into 10 to the power of 3 and pi by 32 into 63 into d cube, that is d we got as 51.7. so we got d here as 47.6 and 51.7. so to satisfy this both conditions, we have to take larger of the values, that is nothing but d as 51.7, say the nearest standard value is 55 mm. So this is the diameter, and this is the way to calculate diameter of the shaft in these cases. So let us see once again in a fast manner what we have done. So here shaft is given, which is given with two pulleys with some belt arrangements. So because of this loads and these arrangements, the shaft is subjected to vertical loads and horizontal loads. We have calculated vertical load, horizontal loads here, and we have calculated vertical movements and horizontal movements because of these loads. If you see here, we have calculated the reaction forces and we have calculated vertical movements at C and D, and we have calculated horizontal movements. We have calculated equivalent resultant movements at C and D, and we have taken maximum movement, maximum resultant as a maximum bending moment acting on the shaft, and torque we have found out in the previous cases, and the two torque and maximum bending moment we are equating to the twisting, equivalent twisting moment. We are finding out equivalent twisting moment and equivalent bending moment with these two values, and those we are equating to the twisting strength of, that is equivalent twisting moment to the twisting strength of the shaft, and equivalent bending moment of the to the bending strength of the shaft to find out the diameter of the shaft. So this is the way to solve this kind of questions. So for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol. Please like it, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.